If you have a .NET Framework web application, did you know that you can containerize it and its dependencies, publish it to a container registry, and then deploy it to Azure App Service? Take advantage of what the cloud has to offer by moving your application to Azure. Andrew Westgarth is here to show us how, today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Andrew, and he's going to show us how to take our .NET Framework applications, all of their dependencies, and run them inside of a Windows container inside of Azure. This is exciting stuff because so much talk is about just port it to .NET Core, and that is not always an option for a lot of us. We want to take our .NET Framework apps, and we just want to lift and shift them into PaaS, and this sounds like it's going to be a great way to do that.
Yeah, exactly. We looked at our customer base. And most there's a large customer base of .NET Framework apps who are not on Azure yet.
Me.
So we're like, how do we enable that? How
sure.
do we enable customers that are in cloud service or on their own data centers? They've got contracts running out. They've got applications they don't maintain anymore. The contractor, they don't even know them anymore.
Sure.
How do we get them into Azure and principally into Azure App Service?
Right.
The other things that we look at is customers have dependencies in some of these applications. So they have database clients that they need to use. They have libraries that need to be installed in the GAC. Well, we don't allow you to do that in App Service because we don't allow you to have access to the underlying infrastructure. It's all about your code.
Right.
With a Windows container, you can put those dependencies directly inside your container and then run them on top of our platform.
Great.
So then that opens up new doors for app modernization for a lot of customers.
Yeah, because you just answered the question, because a lot of us are thinking, well, I can already run my .NET Framework apps in App Service. Why do I have to containerize them? And that was the reason why
yeah,
I need to containerize
them. Yeah, it's dependencies. And our sandbox blocks access to certain libraries, say GDI, for
gotcha.
PDF generation, that sort of thing. Is often, we've made changes over the years to support a lot of frameworks, but it doesn't support everything. Whereas now, customers are not blocked by that because the sandbox becomes their container. Not what we have in App Service.
And they can do whatever they need to in their Docker file to make sure that all the dependencies
yep.
are on that machine.
And the only principal requirement is that they're running a HTTP workload.
Okay.
So it communicates over 80.443. It's a web workload. If it's a Windows service, that sort of thing, Azure's got other services that we can help you out with. But App Service is principally about running high-scale web apps, and that's what we want to
cool.
make easy.
So how are you going to show us how to use it today?
Yeah. So I've got Visual Studio 2019 up and running. And the simulation here is that I've already got a .NET app. This is a web forms app,
mm-hmm.
and I want to move it to the cloud. So it has a dependency in place, and I'm stuck. I've got one thing. I can go to IaaS, I go to cloud services, but it's not easy to move around, and I only want to focus on my application. So we're going to make a quick change here, just to show it's real.
Okay.
Save that, and then all we're going to do is add Docker support.
Okay.
So we just have this one menu option. And what happens is Visual Studio then gives us a Docker file. And if I minimize the Solution Explorer, we have here the information of what our base image is. For .NET Framework applications, we need to build our containers off a base image of Windows Server Core. For .NET Core, we can use Windows Server Nano.
Right.
And they are very different in terms of capabilities. One of the things that we have now in App Service is support for Server 2019 hosts,
okay.
which means that we can use Server Core 2019 images, and that's what we're going to do here. And we just have to just now publish that to a container registry, and then we can make it available to our app. Once we go into App Service, we can pull it down.
Sure. Like, so we can either use Docker Hub or ACR, or any registry we really want to.
Exactly. So okay. today I'm going to use Docker Hub,
okay.
just to show that we can use any custom registry or whichever you feel comfortable with.
Okay.
So I'll just log into Docker Hub. You can build a DevOps pipeline for all of this, and
sure.
you can go into much more detailed demos. But today, we just want to show very simple, how do I get quickly up and running and take advantage of everything that we have built into the platform.
And this is the process most of us are going to take the first time we do it anyway.
Exactly.
Right?
And then we'll go around and we've explored. Now, how do I get this with one of my real apps and my production apps and those sort of things?
Exactly.
And to go back to that comment that I made about the container sizes, moving from 2016 host support to 2019 is a massive difference. So we go from here. This is a 2016 image.
Right.
Nearly 14 gig in size.
Yeah, it's always been the bane of our existence. It's just they're too big.
And then below, thanks to the awesome work the Windows Server team have been doing on making sure that those container images have only got the bare minimum that they actually need in, we're down to 5.32 gig.
That's fantastic.
And then on Nano, I think they've got that down to about 340 meg. So if you're doing .NET Core, then you know, you're away.
Absolutely.
So.
Very cool. I'm really glad to see the improvement in the size, because that's something that always comes up when you want to move to Windows containers.
So we're just waiting for VS to publish that, but there we go. We've got the publishing going on now. And that's been published up to Docker Hub. It's compiling all the layers, getting everything to put up. The key thing with Windows containers is to make sure that you don't have unnecessary layers. So a container is built of various layers, your base image plus your application and any changes, as you'll see there in the publish window. And the key thing is to A, use a base image that a service caches. So we cache the 2019 4.72 image or the Nano Server 1809 image for .NET Core.
Okay.
That way, when we pull a customer's image, we don't have to pull that. We've got it already. And then we're just pulling the differences and then spinning it up.
Great. So that, so even though it's a 5 gigabyte image, you're not going to pay the price of it being a 5 gigabyte image because it's cached in App Service for you anyway.
Yeah, we're only going to pull your application layers effectively or your dependencies. And even there's ways you can build your Docker file so that you actually put those dependencies in, but then remove the transient layers so that you can smush it down and be a lot more efficient on how you build your containers.
Fantastic.
So we have the container here built, and that's up and running in my Docker Hub. So now I'm going to go into the Azure portal, and we're going to create a web app. And this is something anybody's used App Service before or not. Very familiar, very comfortable, something that they can do. We'll just give it a name. And we have a choice in App Service, Windows, Linux, Code, or Docker image. Now we have parity there. And I'm going to create a new App Service plan. So an App Service plan is effectively the infrastructure underneath that we have running for all App Service apps. And for Windows containers, we offer some of the most powerful equipment that we have available in App Service because they need different types of hardware underneath to run.
Okay.
So we have everything from an 8 gig at the low end, in terms of RAM, up to a 32 gig machine on the PC4 end. Okay. And I'm going to choose one of those PC4s right now.
It's always fun.
Yeah. and let's give that a name. And we have some location support. We're in 6 regions right now while we're in public preview. We're looking at seeing what customers are doing. We've expanded those over the year to give us more regions. And today I'm going to choose West US because that's closest to us where we're recording. And then I go in and configure my container.
And all you're doing here is putting in the actual image tag.
Yeah, this right here. So here's my image tag that I got. That's the application, Azure Friday's web app, and then latest, which is my tag.
Yeah.
And then we just apply. And we do validation as well to make sure that you're not deploying a Linux container into a Windows machine and so on, and that the actual container is valid. Because we want you to fail here, not after you've managed to spin an app up and we try and do a Docker pull and everything fails. We're trying to have a fantastic experience for the end user and the customer. So
we,
in the meantime, we're building that and we'll wait for the application to come up and then we'll do an initial request, which is then where we kick off the pull.
Okay.
And that's when the worker says, right, okay, I need to go and do some work, and we do the pull. And we're looking at ways in which we can optimize that experience as we go forward. We optimize for server core because the images are so big. Anybody deploying a Nano image just gets the benefits because if we optimize for the harder problem, then off we go. So there's my app, there's my app service plan, and there's my website. Very familiar. Certain features are grayed out because they're not there yet or they don't apply.
Okay.
But as we get closer towards a GA product, more and more of those features that people know and love about App Service will come up. So we're just waiting for that container to spin up. In the background, we're doing a Docker pull, getting it all unpacked, extracting all the layers and having it run. And while we're doing that, we look at some of the demos of some of the scenarios that we can solve with this problem. So here's a support for custom fonts. Again, they need to be installed into the machine, but now you install them into the container, we can make use of those. This one is PDF generation, so if you do this with certain libraries, you'll get yellow screen of death, this sort of thing in App Service. So we don't want that now. That fully functions and works. And here's another one, a custom culture. So this is something that needs to be installed into the GAC. Again, that's something we don't allow in App Service, but now you can do that. It's the same for MSIs. So I've got a demo where I actually use an Access database, which is stored in Azure File Share.
Okay.
Connected to App Service, but then I can read it using Jet from my .NET framework to App, and that's a common thing in enterprise. You know, I spent enough time in that kind of world that I know that these things happen. So,
access is like VB, like it's everywhere. You're never going
to. If it isn't broke, don't fix it.
Exactly. Exactly. It's still doing, getting the job done. So yeah, this is again, this is really going to be exciting for people who have large legacy full framework applications, and we all do, right? We all have those applications. And
there's the demo up and running.
Very cool.
So that's taken the container, pulled it down, unpacked. I used the base image that we cache, so all it needed was my layers. So if we go into the, we can even show that piece off by looking at the container logs, and we can see what we've actually done.
Yep.
So you see that already exists. And then we realize, we have this layer.
Some things. Exactly.
And we're talking a few K for a layer.
Yeah. And it's interesting. So instead of just using App Service itself, we were sort of forced to kind of use containers because it gives us that sandbox that allows us to do our own dependencies. But forcing our hand there has given us this portability that comes with being in a Docker container,
yes.
Right? The image and as more platforms support Windows images, you're just going to be able to pull that down and run it in so many other places, which is, I think, the true power and benefit of Docker is that you build your image once, you deploy it as many times in as many places as you like.
Certainly, and within App Service, we give you auto-scale,
yep.
We give you the scale-up, scale-out, we can do that automatically for
Deployment
you.
Deployment slots are in there?
Deployment slots, we've had those for ever since the preview started. We've got things like WinRM. You can WinRM into your container, but you don't have to customize your container to enable it.
Oh, nice.
We do that for you, so when your container's up and running, we're able to inject the module and then be able to open up WinRM. We could do the same thing with SSH, other services, and that's where we're looking at the value add of App Service. How can we enable these scenarios but still give you that portability of the container?
Fantastic.
If you lose that portability of the container, then we haven't implemented correctly.
Correctly, so
that's
yeah,
what
yeah
we're,
exactly.
We're driving forward with, and that's what our feature gates is all the time.
Well, this is always exciting to see the Windows world embracing the container world so much so that we're not going to have to rewrite. Because the answer cannot always be just rewrite it in .NET Core. That's not an answer. This is an answer. Just
an answer,
do what you did before. Right-click, add Docker support, publish your app, and enjoy all the benefits.
Yep.
Awesome. We're learning all about taking your full framework applications and containerizing them inside of a Windows container and running them in Azure here on Azure Friday.